Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have talked about what is solubility as well as molar solubility, as well as we have also talked about what is solubility product, and based on that we are going to derive or we are going to relate the solubility product with that of the solubility. So let us do it. So for example, if we have to give the relation between the solubility product and the solubility, so how can we make it? But before understanding that most of the the source, they might be they can be dissociated when it has been dissolved in water, so therefore they are we call it as very sparingly soluble salt. So that sparingly soluble salts, they don't dissociate completely into their respective cations or anions, and that is what the main, that is solubility product, emerges from. So for example, suppose if I take an example like this one, that is, if I'm talking about like that is the salt BA, and in this case suppose I would write it over in this way, that is BX along with that of AY. So this is basically the stoichiometry that I'm talking about. So now suppose if it has been dissociated in such a way, that is if it is a complete sparingly soluble salt, so now it will be dissociated into basically X moles of B having a charge of, that is Y plus, suppose. So similarly, according to that, I could get, that is Y moles of A with a charge of X minus. So this is what we have got over here. So these are the respective ions that we could get over here. So even I am going to talk about the examples that I will explain after this. So we can also that is express the solubility product in this case, and the solubility product, that is, it is denoted by Ksp, and it can be, as it is, as I have mentioned earlier also, that is, it is nothing but the product of the concentration of the ions that has been produced because of an electrolyte, and that is what the products that are been obtained is basically By plus. But the stoichiometry of this one is X, so it will be raised to X, and that of the other product, that is basically AX minus, I would write it over here. Actually, this Y should be above it, and that could be written as, the stoichiometry is basically Y, so I would write it over here as Y raised to Y. So this is what I have got over here, that is the solubility product. But talking about the solubility, if I talk, that is, this is the concentration that we have got for, that is B raised to Y plus, or that has a charge of Y plus. So I could write it in this way also, that is the concentration of, that is B raised to Y plus, is nothing but the product of the stoichiometry that I have got over here, and that is basically X into solubility, and that solubility will be basically moles per dm cube, because I'm talking about the molar concentration in this case, and talking about the another one, that is for the product, that is AX minus. So therefore I could write it over here as AX minus, which can be equal to the stoichiometry of that, it is basically Y, and again that will have a particular solubility, and that is basically S moles in dm cube. So this is what we have, and that is the concentration that we have over here, and that could be expressed in this way. So therefore if I relate this with the equation, that is what I have got over here as Ksp, so therefore I could write it over here as, that is the Ksp or the solubility product, instead of the concentration, I would have to write it over here as, basically for By plus, I will write it, that is X S raised to X, and into, basically for AX minus, I will write it over here as Y S raised to, that is here raised to Y. So I will write it over here as this one. So if I equate it, then I could get, that is X raised to X into S raised to X multiplied by, that is Y raised to Y into S raised to Y. So this can be written in this form, that is X raised to X and Y raised to Y into S raised to X plus Y. So this is what we have got over here, and that is nothing but the relationship between, that is the solubility product and the solubility. So this is what we have got over here, and that is makes the relationship between them. And let me talk about that is the few examples and I would relate this. And for example, if I'm talking about the electrolyte like that of the AlOH thrice, so in this case I will give you the values of that, what is X and what is Y. Suppose in this case the value of before understanding that, let me give them an expression that how it will dissociate. So therefore it will dissociate into basically that is Al 3 plus plus OH, that is 3 times of OH I will get over here. So therefore 3 moles of OH, and each OH consists of minus charge on it. So therefore if I relate this, then here I could get the value of X as 1, Y as basically I would get it over here as 3. So this is what we could get. And suppose if I have to calculate the solubility product, then it is very much easy to do that. But let us understand that how can we write it. So therefore the KSP will be equal to X raised to X, that is in this case I will write it over here, that is X raised to S, X Y raised to Y, and solubility, that is S, would be X plus Y. So in this case the stoichiometry, that is I would see over here, that is for Al the X is basically 1, and that's the reason that the charge that is deposited on it, and that will be basically Y plus, and in this case the Y is basically 3, and that of the OH will, each OH will have an acquiring the charge of that is X minus, and that is minus 1 in this case. So therefore only the thing that we have to do is we have to substitute the value over here. So therefore for X it is 1 raised to X, that is 1 raised to 1. For Y it is 3, so therefore this is 3 raised to 3. And for solubility I will write it over here as solubility, and for this X plus Y, and in this case the X is 1 and Y is 3, so therefore it would be written as basically 4. So therefore for aluminum trihydroxide the solubility product can be written as, that is KSP, which is equals to 1 raised to 1, that is 1 itself, and 3 raised to 3, that is 27, into S raised to 4. Or I could write it as 1 plus 3 also, but it is S raised to 4. So this is what the solubility product for the aluminum trihydroxide. And in that case, suppose if we know the solubility of the aluminum trihydroxide, in that case we could easily calculate the KSP, or if we know the KSP, we can easily calculate the solubility of the aluminum trihydroxide, and that's what we could relate it with. So this is basically the relationship between the solubility as well as the solubility product of a particular electrolyte or of a particular substance, and that is what I wanted to talk about. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly and you have got to know the relationship between the solubility and the solubility product, and I hope you will share this video with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.